I've got a little bit of bruise. Today is the morning of an exam. The applied medical knowledge test. So this is where they test you on everything. I'm not nervous, I'm gonna get it over with really. It's a 3-hour exam, it's quite long.
So yeah, what are you saying, right?
Just gotta go in there with level head and gotta come out with level head.
Fairs.
That's all.
Fairs. What's an exam to medical exams?
Don't panic.
Don't panic, yeah, fairs. Yeah. Just, you're the pro at the exams. What are you saying, how are you feeling?
I'm chill. Be fine.
Post-exam reaction, so I think I lasted a bit under 2 hours, yeah, what were you saying?
I feel pretty much the same as I did going in.
Yeah. We're going to play some pool now, just to de-stress. Yeah.
This is needed right now.
We're going to play some pool, de-stress a bit, because it was a really long exam. But yeah, you know, I'm feeling like I'm happy that it's over. Cool pool montage. Respectable.
What happened is that, and then
the guy won. Anyway, it's respectable though. I had 2 balls left, it's fine.
The next morning.
Okay, so beacon coffee, espresso review.
That's an A. That says it's fruity and it's there's no aftertaste.
Nice.
And we've got the water here as well.
So I'm doing a great job of filming it.
Yeah, 8.
Nice.
8 out of 10.
I can't handle it because I'm a little baby man.
Oh, yeah.
Can't handle the espresso.
It's good though, I like that.
You like the Americano?
Mm, yeah.
There you go. What do you give it out of 10?
I'll probably give that a 7 to me.
A 7?
Yeah.
There you go.
Cheers, boys. To the new
term. To the new term.
I wanted to talk today about mental health. Like January, February, I find are just difficult months because there's such a build up to Christmas and then it's over and you've kind of got nothing to look forward to.
Yes?
Sorry to interrupt. Would you like some chocolate panettone to go with your old fashions?
Joe, you gotta make a cameo, my guy.
Cameo?
Yeah.
Thank you so much.
The guy who brings the panettone.
Thanks, Mom. No worries, guys. Thanks. Always enjoy yourselves.
Don't do anything I wouldn't do.
As soon as you come back, the thing I look forward to is the end of term, which is always ages away. No, I feel like just like going out with your mates, like just learning to have fun, just trying like break out of that cycle, trying to like just have fun in the right now rather than looking forward to something in the future.
Yeah. I'd say like the thing I do is I check in like once in a while when I feel down and I just like literally say to myself the reasons why I'm doing medicine. Because if you can kind of bring back to why you're doing something, like that helps.
Having people, whether it's like tutors, you know, your professional development tutor, you can talk to him about anything.
Yeah.
Having friends, being kind to yourself,
yeah,
and just like saying, you know what? Today wasn't it. I had a really awful day because of X, Y, and Z. But that's okay. And I'm gonna do this to make myself feel a bit better.
I'd say, yeah, just like sort of being kind to yourself is always really good. Obviously, don't take that to its extreme. Like, you do actually have to put in some work.
Yeah. You can't blow your student loan out either.
Actually, yeah, managing money is actually... Yeah. Learn to manage money, actually.
That's what I mean. So you've got the workload. You've got to have work-life balance, which I think lots of... Like, there are degrees out there where it's a lot like that. Lots of work, work-life balance is difficult. And another thing that's quite stressful is when you realise that, you know, it's a five-year degree. So it's really long. And like you go into it at 18, 19, and you come out of it a man, you're like 22, 23, and that is also a bit strange.
You do come out of it fully mature.
You're spending like, by the time we finish, we're fully matured adults.
Yeah.
At this point. And we've spent most of our entire life in school, basically.
Literally.
We would have spent all of our adult life thus far.
In school.
Yeah. Preparing for exams.
Yeah, in uni. Mm.
Yeah, so I feel like just going out into the real world after that is going to be a big thing as well.
Don't make medicine and med school your entire life.
Yeah.
Because that is depressing.
Yeah.
Like, that is so depressing.
It gets really sad really quickly.
Yeah. Just to be, like, good at other things and remind yourself that you're a good person when medicine is going bad.
Yeah.
Because if that's your only source of self-esteem, then if it's going bad, you're going bad.
Yeah.
Self-checks often.
Yeah.
Like, how did this past week go? Oh, it wasn't too great. Okay, well, what am I going to do about that? Well, I have, like, I can do this, this, and this. Fine.
I sort of, like, try and treat it a bit like a 9-to-5. I have set hours of the day where I work and I'm more productive.
Yeah.
And then I just try and take nights off. Like, obviously, there's something big coming up, or if I haven't done something, I'll work during the night, but I try and take most of my nights off.
Me too.
Just because that's what I wanted to relax, you know?
That's clear. I think, how we all finished?
Yeah.
Let's go.
I think that's a first, I won't lie.
Yeah, we've all finished. Yeah, and we finished the chocolate. Joe, thanks for the chocolate panettone, my guy.
Casey joins the hollow sound of silent people walking down the stairway to the subway in the shadows down below.
So what are these called?
What they think would be a reasonable amount
for meals.